two men came together for the referee's instructions. The height advantage of Francesco Patera, who ended the unbeaten run at 17 of Lewis Ritson in Newcastle in 2018. Beaten three times in his career, Patera, but still very confident that he can make it through to the top. As Pasquiera starts in lively fashion, but Patera has a way of covering up. He's very efficient in terms of defence, using the elbows and in this case the gloves as well, and fires away with a solid right hand to the body as his response in the early stages.
He tops up for this one, Pasquiera. You see him in the ring walk, no nonsense, straight in the ring, growling at Patera. That's a good positive start. Reflects his attitude, a little football. Tough, strong, rugged. Patera moving nice to the back foot, weathering the storm, boxing nice behind that jab. Doesn't look unfazed.
And take those shots on the elbows and on the gloves and then fire back when he gets the opportunity for an open.
Some good work to the body from Patera. Sitting the arm there with Pasquiera. It's a wise move to target the body of the older man, try to slow him down. It's gone to Martin J. Ward, who shared the ring with Pasquiera. He said it's very slippery, very awkward, very tough to hit, but extremely fit. Great shape, didn't stop.
Yeah, six defeats on the card of Pasquiera, but only one of those was inside the distance, and that against Stephen Smith all the way back in 2015 in Liverpool when he was stopped in six rounds. Good jab from Patera. Smart work there, and then opens up with the right hand that was taken off the club by Pasquiera. Two seasoned campaigners here, and Pasquiera is surely with his last chance to climb the ladder.
We'll go back to that Stephen Smith performance. He just got caught going on the right numerous times. Stephen Smith was able to find the target inside and short on what hurts. But there we know we've seen against Ritson, etc. He can find those shots himself. Let the rounds go on. Expect to hear him look for those. But what a game! Exciting start. Pasquiera
burying his head when he came into the chest of Patera and trying to work away on the inside. Patera having success at longer range.
Good fast start for Pasquiera there. But Patera is happy on the back foot. Good shots of his own. Yeah, he did that first round out of the way. He's always going to be a hard to start for Pasquiera. Yeah, but who do you want to put forward? Yeah, is he ready to go? Because does he have it left in him? Is that all to win still there? I thought the contest was there.
Yeah, with the amount that Patera is invested in the body, I think we'll find out in a few rounds' time whether it is. But if you know it's strange circumstances due to fight against Pasquiera earlier this year, but Pasquiera pulled out due to a COVID test in Madison Belmont. He pulled out because one of his team tested positive for him. But then the last minute they got this young guy up there, and Chiri, who stepped in. And I think Patera was completely unmotivated, almost assuming this guy was going to roll over. And the guy was very lucky to get it this evening. I think everybody watching felt that he lost. It was much, much better now in the league. In this contest, he needs to get the win tonight.
Pasquiera now 40. A lot of his successes coming in the super featherweight division. He was European champion and Italian champion at that poundage. And can Patera make his supposedly greater natural strength tell?
You can really see the size difference between the two men. Patera locked all up. Get that reach into play. Jack Holliday, white belt from Patera, and Pasquiera back on his back onto the ropes. Good work.
He likes to catch a cat off the ropes on the left foot there.
Good left to the body. He felt that Pasquiera.
Teixeira landing that right hand again for the second time at the end of that particular exchange. Patera just getting a bit clumsy on the way out of those last two exchanges. Patera now behind the left hand again, switching the attack to the body, trying to gain some kind of control from the centre of the ring.
Tucking up well, Bosquero, but the less of the bodies, the shots. Just missing there with that one. Found it a couple of times. Bosquero, hat's belt though, blunts the nose of Bosquero. Beautiful shots, Jack. Right. Left for a while, left upper cut from Patera. Getting into his rhythm now, getting into his groove.
Good start for Patera as the blood appears on the face of Bosquero, but still the Italian firing back.
A lot more switched off this contest, but
100% that really looks to me to people sense already that he's had a breakthrough, getting through and to Bosquero with ease. And look at the mark now, there's a couple of pink marks just over the right eye of the older man. Where's Bosquero's?
We've seen before, Patera comes back so well on the ropes, he's so efficient in finding the roots for those four shots, but again, Bosquero lands that right hand on the way out, and he's trying to roar him forward.
Game for Bosquero, it's a bloody mess already, up the two rounds. It isn't cut to the right eye, the nose is busted. What's the ball? Patera has really got into his rhythm this round.
That cut to the right eye seems to have worsened as the round has gone on. A couple of jabs have landed on it or very close to it as Patera confidently strides back to his corner.
He's got this definitely years of scar tissue built up. It's not possible to get older and there's this lead here with low body fat too. It's brush out of you. I feel like that's kind of like hoops that Patera's throwing.
And that will and desire, your body can tell you one thing and your mind something else. When it starts getting tough, when you're miles on the clock, it really, really is difficult. Unfortunately, you'll get there at some point and you do start to feel the pace. You can see the bloody mess. After two rounds, and like I said, Patera is really getting into his groove. Start to enjoy
himself. So into the third round. Was that a significant sequence of action there in the second round? Is Patera now really beginning to get on top? There was a buoyancy about his work, particularly his footwork, skipping around the ring, starting to enjoy what he was doing, and there, lovely, short, sharp left hand. But once again, Teixeira knows only one response, and that's to come back at his opponent, covering up well as he steps back there, Bosquero.
Yeah, good to build on that good second round. Teixeira has come out positive on that nice snapping jab. Again, that left to the body, that really is the shot. That's the shot that started to double Bosquero in the second round. The back comes the tough Italian. So well, he's got a great engine, but he doesn't get trapped into a fight. Or, I mean, it could be a case that he drags you into a fight, but one thing's for sure, he can keep it going and he can get stuck in.
Bosquero having success with a flipping left hook on the ropes on that far side of the ring. And despite the damage to his face, he is managing to carry a lot of these punches from Patera on the gloves, but now the referee wants to check with the doctor after a terrific left uppercut from Patera, and Bosquero really felt that, and he's going to struggle to see out of that for the remainder of the contest, and you can't really see how this is going to be allowed to continue. The referee will take the instructions from the doctor, and the doctor there with his passing of the head of Bosquero suggests that it's all over. And so here in the third round, the referee on the Francesco Patera scores another victory and moves on towards what he says is still very much the aim, a crack someday at the world title.
That's hard luck, it's a tough way for the fight to finish. You see the shot, he picked it out perfectly there, but it was a left tackle cut. It's obviously dragged up. Damage was caused.
Well, at the age of 40, and in this his 58th fight, you have to wonder what's left for Davis Bosciero from Veneto, just along from here on the east coast of Italy. But a good win for Francesco Patera. Showed some very clean, clinical punching over the course of the first 2.5 rounds or so. So efficient in defence, so calculating at times in attack. And yes, the challenges will get much more difficult from here on if he really is aiming at the highest prizes. But it's another win for Francesco Patera at the age of 28, his 25th of his career.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Stefan Niccolò calls a halt to this contest. The official time of the stoppage, 1 minute and 32 seconds of round number 3. New winner by TKO and the new WBO Intercontinental Lightweight Champion, Francesco Patera.
Patera more than satisfied with his night's work, WBO Intercontinental.